Well, the moment has passed. Back to work.
G'day all, Mr. Paladin here, and it's time for another video log where I get in touch with you as fans to let you know what's happening with the channel, read some mail, get you caught up with what I've been doing, and stuff like that. And right now, the first thing I want to hit right out of the gate is the fact that the channel is almost 250,000 subscribers. That is just amazing to me. The love and support you guys give, I thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you for the support. Thank you for the likes on Facebook, Twitter, all the social medias. Thanks for all the thumbs up on the videos. It all really does help. So thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So what's been happening recently is me and the family went on a trip to Jamaica and Cozumel, Mexico. We had a lot of fun. In Jamaica, we went to a place called Magic Mountain, went up a cable car, and there's a bobsled at the top. Me and a Megabot were having a good time on the cable car up to the top and on the bobsled down. In Cozumel, Mexico, we did a lot of fun stuff, including having a like a glass bottom boat type submarine thingy, and that was really fun, and me and Goblin King enjoyed that a lot. So in those times where I do take a vacation with the family, I really do like to unplug from the internet and just have a pure family vacation. And I find like going on cruises is great for that, because when you're on a cruise, the best internet connection you're gonna have is a satellite internet connection. And anyone who's ever had a satellite internet connection knows that it is not the best connection. It's really high latency, not a great amount of throughput, stuff like that. So yeah, you unplug, you spend time with the family, and you really bond like that. So that's what I like doing with the family on vacations, when we can take them. In a recent video, you got to see the new ferrets in the house, and the ferrets have been taking over the channel ever since. Those who have been with the channel for a long time knew that we've had my pets on the channel every now and then, but let me introduce you to the current ferrets that we have. This is Jerry. Jerry's a new member of the house. Even he's been keeping Lewis a lot of company, and we got him at the same time as Jerry. And yeah, he's very inquisitive. He likes to get around. He likes to run around and play. He loves the toys that like jingle and crinkle. He loves jingling and crinkling, don't you? Yeah, you do. This is Lee. Lee is our smallest and youngest ferret right now. He is very dark, and he looks like a little bitty bear. I love him. He's so freaking adorable. Yeah, aren't you? Say hello to everyone. They're, what? What are you gonna do? He just wants to get down and run around right now. And anyone who's been on the channel for a while knows Lewis. Lewis is my tamest and my friendliest ferret. He's been on the channel before. He's been in several videos. One time taking over my computer and, you know, playing a game of Team Fortress 2 with Clark. And yeah, he's very friendly. You could come up and pat him, no problem. He's one of my tamest. Now, in response to all the adoring fans that the ferrets have right now, I think they've got me a bunch of subscribers just by being ferrets themselves. My daughter made up this new cup that features Jerry, Lee, and Lewis on it. And that's going up on the store for this Christmas, so be sure and pop into the store if you're interested in stuff like that. If you're looking for any Mr. Paladin merchandise, it's on the store. The links are in the video description. If you're still looking for stuff for Christmas, like real personalized stuff, either Mr. Paladin stuff, or if you have your own pet or something and you want to surprise someone with something of their own pet, my daughter can make stuff like that custom, but you know, get in touch with her, make sure it's cool. She can do you a private listing and stuff, but it's the same link, just send an email to the store. So if you've been watching recent videos, you might have noticed a small change. For a while I was having trouble with volume controls, and I came to find out it was because of my other headset. What it was I particularly got a replacement headset for this exact type of headset, because it had on its cord, it had like a digital control for the volume. But the trouble with that was it was literally changing the Windows volume setting in the lower right, you know, down in the system tray, instead of, you know, just being a volume control for my ears. So it ended up You know, because I didn't want my ears blasted out, I was having things on low volume, and that was recording it low, making editing a problem, and then you guys couldn't hear it. So I'm going back to this Logitech, what is it, a G430? Yeah, a G430. So that should improve some of the sound on the videos that we've got at the moment. Also, if you happen to watch a recent video, I have been using this eye tracker. It sits on the bottom of my screen, and it uses three cameras. Let's see, those little red lights. It uses the three cameras to track what I'm looking at on the screen, and I'm going to be doing up some more videos of that really soon. I just wanted to do a trial one to see what people thought about it. If you want to see it, I'll put a link up there or something, and you'll be able to click on it and have a look at what that's all about. And now for a fun part of the video, where I get to open up some letters from y'all. So let's get the letters going. There's my handy dandy letter opener here. And let's see who this is from. This is from Isabella. So it says, "Dear Mr. Paladin, thank you for reading my letter. Also, sorry for my sloppy handwriting. Even though I'm older, I still have the handwriting of a kid because of my hand-eye coordination." Oh, that's no problem. My handwriting's terrible also. That's why I end up typing everything I do these days. Anyway, Isabella goes on to say, "Your channel helps me out whenever I'm having a hard time, because I've always worked hard in school, and in fact, I've always had to work harder than most people. That's because when I was 5 years old, I was diagnosed with ADD. You know what? A lot of people are having that, and actually, I find a lot of gamers have that these days. Let's see. I still have a hard time picking up social cues. Luckily, I've gotten older. My learning problems have gotten much easier to deal with. Awesome, awesome. And I'm very smart." Yeah, no kidding, in college. "So I have learned to deal with my problems." Isabella goes on to say, "I sent you some cactus candy as a thank you for being a really great guy. Feel free to share with your wife and kids. From Isabella. P.S. My dad is also not from the U.S. My dad was born and raised in the Dominican Republic and came to the U.S. with a dual citizen. Okay, by a dual citizenship." Okay, excellent. Actually, I've got to get my American citizenship in order. Goodness. So there is, again, the prickly pear candy, and I'm going to try that out with the family and see what they think about it. Okay, we've got another letter here from Ben, and Ben says that he is inspired by my amazing spy work. "I also love how you make your videos as tutorials instead of just showing people how good you are and just making jokes." Ben goes on to say, "I also see you're good at other classes too. It amazes me how good you are." Well, thank you. You know, that's kind words. I'm not the greatest at a bunch of stuff, but, you know, I just like having fun and playing a bunch of different classes. But that's besides the point, he goes on to say. "I have my own YouTube channel and hope to be like you." Awesome, awesome. It takes time to grow, and it takes time for people to share around your stuff to the point where YouTube starts spreading it out itself, you know? Ben goes on to say that he has about 70 hours in TF2, and he still has a lot to learn. He was wondering if he could do a collab sometime on a YouTube video, but I can't tell if you're Australian or not. Well, you know, if you check the frequently asked questions and the links and stuff, this question comes up a lot. I am Australian, but I'm in the USA, so ping could probably be a problem, stuff like that. I have been doing more social stuff every now and then, popping into people's videos and stuff like that, at least saying hi, you know. You try and be a bit social. I try and do community games as often as I can from my own Discord. If people are just hanging out, we'll jump in a game. Now that there's a party system in TF2, that is more likely to happen. But again, this time of year, some strange stuff happened. We had the vacation, then we had the Pyro update, then I had my birthday and stuff like that. So things haven't been usual right around this time of year. But, you know, just hang out, just be a part of the community, and yeah, stuff like that can happen. They're from Canada. Well, there you go. That solves that problem a bit. I get good enough ping up to Canada. We probably could do a video together. The ping would probably be through the roof. No. I'm in Atlanta, Georgia. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Bye-bye. Yeah, I mean, I like to do stuff like that. I like to like just hang out with the community. I've had to be under an alias a lot. A lot of people found out this next spy video that I've got coming out, I was under an alias, and eventually I switched up to my gear and stuff like that, and people saw through the alias. So then I switched my alias to Mr. Paladin, and once I do that, the server itself goes a little bit crazy. You know, you get three types of people. You get the people who don't believe I'm me, that I'm just some other faker out there. You get people who want to suddenly just only focus on killing me in the hopes of being some sort of center of attention in a video or something like that. And then you get the people who are just enamored by the whole notion that I could be on the server. You know, I'm just a regular guy. Ask Uncle Dane. We just regular people and we like to play games, so. You know, that's why YouTubers have to alias, because things get really, really crazy when we use our actual name or actual gear up on a server, and people, you know, the game just goes out the window in favor of all these other things that go on. Okay, this next letter is from H47. H47, folks might have known him with the channel from Twitter or some of the thumbnails done before. H47 has done some stuff for me. Good guy. It says, "G'day, Mr. Paladin, H47 here. I wanted to write to you for thanking you for creating content that I've enjoyed for multiple years. I've been a loyal subscriber since early 2015, but I have watched almost all of your TF2 videos." You know, some of those old videos, they are really, really old these days. Like, they're from like two computers ago. So if you guys have hardware problems, have a look at my videos that are like really, really old, and you can see how I was dealing with a lot of, you know, frame drops and stuff like that on an older system. I'd like to thank you for giving me that opportunity, whether it be art or a community game. H47's been on stuff. Thanks for being a big part of why I enjoy TF2 and Spy. I hope you enjoy the drawing I've enclosed. It should be something different from what you've received in the past. Best wishes from H47. And yes, it is quite different, so check out this. I mentioned before that I have a really hard time with my artwork and drawing faces, so check out this. We'll hold this up side by side. Let's see, I've got to get the lighting right. There we go. How does that look? Pretty similar? Yep. That's what I'm saying. I have trouble with proportions. I never get it right. So from what I'm seeing, yeah, the eyes in line with the ears, the forehead, the nose, the mustache, the lips, the teeth. That's pretty spot on. Maybe I would have given myself a little bit more hair on the chin, but that's pretty spot on. So thanks for that. I have some other art here that I've also got to put up into frames and stuff like that. Let me grab that right quick. So like I've got to get it so the window doesn't have the light on it. But that was from one of the outros that I've had done before. And I had this other one sent in previously that I wanted to get framed up. You see that? There we go. We were cleaning up and I found this old, it almost feels like a proper cloth map of Skyrim. I didn't even remember that I had this. So it must have been from like a collector's edition or something that I had got of Skyrim. So I'm gonna have to put those up in a frame, get them up on my wall. I've got to swing by and do that. So be sure and check for me the video descriptions whenever you see a video that you don't know what is in it, because sometimes I get really funny with the naming of it or something like that. Check in all the social medias and stuff so you can stay in touch of what's going on. Like when I was on vacation, some of the pictures that you saw pop up here, I had sent those already across social media just to try and stay in touch with fans. I hope you all have the best time this holiday season with everything coming up. Spend some time with the family, spend some time with the loved ones, and I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Ma ci sento a doncino d'amor. Delle belle turbando al riposo, ma ci sento a doncino d'amor.